There is a better way.
In 1969, this was the future.
You can separate people problems, land side, from airplane problems, airside.
Airsides, separate from the terminal, moving people between them.
A system to move people sideways.
To some, it looked like science fiction, but Tampa's leaders, including a young mayor, liked what they saw.
It looked so different to us because it wasn't anything we had seen or were familiar with. But it made sense when you talked about it.
And they talked about it all through construction. The new TIA was rising out of what was once Drew Field, one of Tampa's three air bases during World War II. A new marker just unveiled reminds us of the legacy.
Because of Drew Field getting built here, Dale Mabry right out here wouldn't even exist. It was made to connect directly to MacDill Air Force Base. If you go out there, you don't make a single turn. You go straight in the front gate of MacDill.
But before you imagine Tampa without Dale Mabry, imagine TIA across the bay.
Likely St. Pete Clearwater would be our TIA.
Historian Rodney Kite Powell says Hillsborough County thought about building TIA out in the USF Busch Gardens area, but
they got wind that Pinellas County was wanted to have an international airport. So they figure if we put our airport close to Pinellas County's border, maybe we'll be the ones to get it. Pinellas County won't.
Tampa got it. They built an airport of the future.
Service. Just like an elevator.
And while that old film seems funny now,
please line up A130.
Most agree the airport has stayed in the forefront.
We didn't know exactly what it was going to look like. We hoped it exceeded all expectations.
Flying through the years with a story all its own. Lloyd Sowers, Fox 13 News.